Hello, we have the barbecue out today because there's a growing trend of people outdoor cooking, and last year the UK market was actually the largest in Europe with over £7 billion being spent. On the board we have some kebabs, we have some beef, some pork and some lamb. We have some marinated, so there's flavour options there as well. And we have some plain, which we're going to season up with some salt and pepper and some oil as well. This is just a vegetable oil and it's going to help the seasonings to stick, the salt and the pepper, but it's also going to help it's also going to help the kebabs not to stick to the barbecue. A little bit of crushed rock salt on all sides, just to help season that already beautiful meat. There we go. And then a little bit of black pepper. Over we go. There we go. So the barbecue's up to temperature. We're looking for about 250 to 260 degrees C when we're grilling our meats. So the barbecue's preheated just in the same way that you preheat your frying pan or your grill in the kitchen. And we just pop those on, evenly space them, and close the lid. With the lid closed, we'll reduce the amount of flare-up going on inside the barbecue. Instead of creating flare-up, we'll create smoke, which will circulate around underneath the barbecue lid, penetrating the meat and giving it a wonderful barbecue flavor. The beautiful thing about kebabs is that you can take meat from different parts of the carcass to create a variety of products and keep your shoppers happy. The marinated kebabs that we have on have a chili marinade on them, a sweet chili marinade, but there's literally tens and hundreds of marinades out there that you can add to your product range for your shoppers. So they'll be on for about 2 minutes per side. One way to be sure that your food's ready to turn over is when it doesn't stick to the cooking grate. So you see the lovely char marks and the caramelization stripes we have going on. That's actually the sugars in the protein caramelizing, and that will separate the food from the cooking grate. So we've cooked the kebabs on all four sides for about 2.5 to 3 minutes per side. It's now time to check whether they're cooked. And for that, we're going to use a digital reed thermometer. So taking one of the center pieces of the meat on the skewer, we're looking for a temperature of around about 72 to 73 degrees C. So that one's ready. Got some nice even pieces of meat on the skewers, so everything should cook nice and evenly. And whether it's marinated or just seasoned with the salt and pepper, they should all cook in roughly the same time. If you are selling meats, if you're selling diced meat for your customers to make their own kebabs, and you happen to sell the little wooden skewers, a nice simple tip is that if they take them home and soak the entire pack in water for about 20 minutes, half an hour, use the skewers that they're going to need for that day, but then the rest of them, just drain them off, put them in a freezer bag and pop them in the freezer so that you've always got them soaked and ready to go. So we'll just have a check on these. I'm just going to take the end piece off a few of these skewers for you and we'll slice into them. There we go, nice little bit of pork. And the lamb, again, nice and juicy. And the last one, nice bit of beef. There we go. So, some simple kebabs with and without the marinades. Some simple tips for effective grilling on your barbecues. Any of the dishes can be done in the kitchen on the hob. And hopefully these tips you can pass on to your shoppers and help them to cook absolutely beautiful food at home.